By Armed Forces of the Philippines spokesperson, Colonel Francel Margaret Padilla. Colonel, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, sir. Good afternoon, po.
The AFP had already rejected the call of Congressman Alvarez to withdraw its support from the president. But how does the organization's leaders view this kind of a call coming from any person, much more a member of the government himself?
For us, sir, we look into the position of Sir Alvarez when he spoke about it. Now, while he is a member of the reserve force, he is not an active reserve. And yung pagkasabi niya yun, sir, in what capacity. So he was not speaking as a member of the reserve force. Mm-hmm. So we are looking into hindi siya recovered sa policies and regulations of the AFP in this manner. And we refer that, sir, to higher authorities po. We were informed that the DOJ is actually looking into this. So we would be deferring that to the DOJ.
Pero Colonel, yung tinatanong ko po, yung ano po bang reaksyon ng mga leaders ng AFP nung narinig nila itong mga salitang tong galing kay Congressman Alvarez?
Of course, no, we are looking into the part of the AFP and so we reiterate, sir, our unwavering commitment to professionalism. Hmm. So our Chief of Staff po, General Browner, has been stating that really we are a professional organization, we are united, and we are non-partisan. And so we would be loyal to the Constitution and would strictly adhere to the chain of command.
Despite the AFP already rejecting the call, there may be some who may be, shall we say, sympathetic with the beliefs of Congressman Alvarez and his allies. Does the AFP need to make some sort of loyalty check because of this?
The Chief of Staff, sir, no, has already stated that there is really no need for us to conduct loyalty checks. As of this time, sir, our soldiers, pilots, sailors, and Marines remain dedicated to our mandate of safeguarding the sovereignty and territorial integrity of the Philippines.
Sir,
if you look at the statistics, no, that was conducted during the surveys, there's a very big percentage of trust rating for the AFP, and we would not want this to be tarnished in any ways.
Finally, on this issue, what message does the AFP want to say to any more people who would maybe want to involve the military or the armed forces of the Philippines in any political agenda?
So we have stated that we are nonpartisan and we would like to be excused and not involved in political matters. Our duty is to protect the Filipino people and uphold the rule of law. And we will ensure that peace and development will prevail throughout the nation. So we will continue, sir, to fulfill these responsibilities with integrity, impartiality, and of course, utmost dedication.
Okay, Colonel Padilla, we want to ask you more questions about another issue. Now, the AFP is planning to put up what it calls strategic bases in areas around the country to properly defend our exclusive economic zone. Will you be able to tell us how many bases are being planned to be put up and when can they be completed?
So this is all part of our comprehensive archipelagic mm-hmm. defense concept. We are actually going around the country and looking at strategic points. So naikot na natin, sir, is we've been to Mabulis Island, which is a strategic point in the north. We also looked at protecting our biggest military reservation. So we looked at Dingalan in Aurora, which is also a strategic point, also part of the north. And most recently, sir, we went to Nonoc Island to see how we would be putting up naval bases to secure the Surigao Strait. So far, sir, yun pa lang yung naikot natin. And we're looking at other points as we go along, sir. No? This is in tandem also with our modernization efforts. So we're looking at the near future, sir, as soon as the modernization efforts are approved and moving forward to the succeeding years.
So as of now, the AFP is still at an ocular phase, just looking for areas and looking for strategic areas to where the bases can be put up.
Yes, sir. And also we're looking at multi-role facilities, sir. No? So we do not reinvent the wheel. those facilities that we can use for different purposes, gagamitin na rin po natin siya. So we will necessarily build everything from scratch.
Colonel,
so we can use it for...
Go ahead, ma'am. Go ahead.
We can use it for HADR, for evacuation, pagka pamamay sa kuna. We can also use it for safe houses for our fishermen.
Pwede din po bang gawing jump-off base ng mga RORE missions natin? It will make it easier and faster?
Yes or no? So as I said, it's multi-role. So whatever purpose that it could serve best, that would be befitting to it, sir, we will look into that.
Now, the putting up of those bases, I'm sure, will be seen as a potential escalation of tensions in our waters. How would the AFP respond to those views?
Actually, sir, it's really not geared towards that. No, it's the right of every nation to secure our defenses. So this is all part of fortifying our defense posture.
Okay, just one more, Colonel. We have President Marcos thinking of or welcoming the idea of including Japan in our Balikatan exercises. Has the AFP given a reaction to that? Are they welcoming that idea as well?
Yes, sir. The AFP is welcoming all like-minded nations to be with us because we're also learning from them, from the trainings, as well as looking at how we would be interoperating with different like-minded nations. So we welcome this new players in the game, so to speak.
Colonel Francel Margaret Padilla, the spokesperson of the Armed Forces of the Philippines. Colonel, maraming salamat po.